everyone, it's Perez, and I'm joined by the one and only Nicole Scherzinger.
Hello!
Let me break this down for you. We're chatting right now, but I especially appreciate it because you don't technically have anything to promote right now. You don't have a new album, you don't have a TV show.
Oh, that's what you think.
No. Oh, really? All right, well, let's go right there. There's talks, rumors that you might be in negotiations to appear on the US version of X Factor.
Oh.
Do you know anything about this?
I don't know anything about that one. I don't.
Well, even if you were in talks, there's no way you would tell us. But you could be honest about this next question. Is that something you would even be open to?
Well, I actually did the X Factor in the UK. Which
and
I
you got
like,
very good buzz about that.
Right? I was like, what's this going to be like? Am I going to suck? Because I'm much more comfortable on stage being in the judge's position. But I really enjoyed the experience. It was kind of crazy. You would love it.
I would love it.
It's like you're your own rock star.
Simon Nicole Perez. Let's make it happen.
Okay. We'll put it out there, people. We'll put it out there.
The secret.
Okay. It was just a lot of fun, and Simon Cowell was just brilliant.
He is.
And Louis was just the sweetest thing ever and lovely, and it was just a great
And was
experience.
Cheryl out when you were doing
Cheryl
it?
Cheryl was out, so it was
she
just
had malaria.
She did. That is not a laughing matter.
No, she's okay now. She's okay now.
She had malaria.
She did.
No, bless her. I was like, oh,
wait,
horrible.
Speaking of Cheryl, you were on Dancing with the Stars with her guy. I wouldn't say it's her boyfriend because I don't think they're dating.
Really?
I think he's like her main gay. I don't know if he's gay. He's got the gay face. He does.
No.
He loves pussy. You're hesitating.
You could say it that way.
Have you seen him make out with a girl? Well, even if he makes out with
ladies.
I don't know. He's Mormon.
He went out with Shannon Elizabeth.
Exactly. Beard.
A solo album.
So this means no Pussycat Dolls for the indefinite future.
Not for the indefinite future.
But they were recast. There are new Pussycat Dolls.
I don't know what's going on with that. There's always Pussycat Dolls. There's the dolls from the lounge in Vegas and all that. So inside everyone is a Pussycat Doll, actually. So do you like how I'm answering these questions?
Yeah.
But no, so I know that I haven't left the Pussycat Dolls.
Okay.
So that's there. But I'm still working on my album, which I'm totally excited. And I remember the last time I didn't come out with my album and you took me aside and you're like, this is what we want, blah, 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 blah. And
are you giving that?
Honey.
What I said to her was, you had the great fortune of becoming very successful in a pop group. And then when you started doing your solo material, it was way different. Not way different, but it was left of that. It was way, way more urban, a harder edge to it. Which could be alienating to the pop fan.
The album's not finished, but it's almost finished. I have a song coming out in fall, and I'm gonna
That's soon.
I'm gonna play you some stuff.
The leaves are changing.
Do you wanna hear it?
Yeah, I'd love to. And as if you were busy enough, you did Rent.
Yes, and I'm so excited to talk about it. You're the first person to like talk to me about
it. I know, I was really impressed. Like I saw all these clips on YouTube and I mean, I know you can sing, but it's more than just singing. It's also acting and it's just being that kind. And also like you're filling into the shoes of Idina Menzel, who's like iconic and such a diva
brilliant.
And legendary. And everybody who I know that saw it, I couldn't see it unfortunately, but everybody was like, she was the standout, the breakout, amazing. So what was that experience like?
It was just crazy. I learned everything a week before.
You're lying. Here's why. I know people that know you.
Okay.
And they tell me that you are always so prepared for everything and you work really hard at everything.
Yes.
So you didn't learn it all in a week. I'm sure you were familiar with it for a week. You started working on it more than a week before.
Let me tell you the true story. You
true
ready?
Story.
Me and you right here. No one else. Only us.
Okay.
Million. I'm saying there's a million people watching right now. I'm just putting it out there, okay? So literally, we started on a Monday. You should have seen me in rehearsals. I looked like a... I'm not going to say it. Like
okay.
A crazy woman. Everybody was on it. Like, didn't have their things. I'm like glued to the page and I was like, do you know
La Bohème. Viva La Bohème.
Oh my gosh. Are you kidding me? It was like such a tongue twister. I'm like, bisexual, on overload that Monday, my head exploded. Everybody was on it, and I didn't know my stuff. And
but you got it together very quickly.
On the because there's not just take me or leave me. There's other things that Maureen needs to
learn. Yeah, over the moon.
Exactly, plunking it on the piano, trying to figure it out. And then I went home in my living room, and I just ran over the moon like over and over and over. Yeah, that was it. It was just all the magic of my living room and just kind of being stupid and the great people around me to inspire me.
Not everything about Rent was positive, though.
Okay, give it.
Vanessa Hudgens.
Stop it right now. We're not talking about Rent anymore. She's a girl. And I loved the cast. They were my family.
Why do you think Neil cast her?
Because he wanted to... I think that he wanted it to be unexpected and her to, like... take on a challenge and do something unique and different, not what people would expect. So same reason why maybe he cast me, because I think people would expect me to maybe have played the Mimi character working at the Cat Scratch Club and everything, and then I'm a lesbian performance artist. Holla!